is he that is in me, that he that is in the world. You are not another cultist asking me, do you know who I am? What is the problem? They were still checking their mothers because they are cut balls. And my brother Joseph, pastor, leave them. Pastor, leave them. And they raised their hand because as I was asking, what is the problem? One raised his hand, he said, I want to slap you. As he raised his hand, I heard my brother said, pastor, leave them. The one that raised hand, he began to see. He said, hey, I don't know, say you be pastor. We they fear pastor. We they fear pastor. We they hear me. You are not ordinary. I say you are not ordinary. I have not shown myself only to hear. I am a pastor. The hand was shaking on air. Today I decree upon somebody, by this power, the enemy of your life will bow before you.
Amen.
Let me hear a louder amen. They could have finished me there. But hearing the Lord that I am a pastor, the hand begin to shake. I am a pastor. I am a pastor. And to end it, they were asking me, and since we have come, give us transport to go. Now me transport you come here. Give us. I come back in with you because we are not on the same pedestal.
Yes, sir.
Me give you transport to go back. What are you talking? And that is how they vamoosh. Today your enemy will vamoosh.
Amen.
Power. You need power. The need for the power. When those two cold boys finished their own, the boy that brought them, that we were in the same apartment there. It was the boy that brought them. I said, no. Since you have, you said that you have a friend that you can fight. Here cannot be comfortable for two of us. I wasn't a landlord. I was not the caretaker. I had the law, this boy must leave. Overnight, the boy disappeared out of the house. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
When he left, it was his room. When I want to do my marriage, I now you for my guest. Oh my God. You don't understand. Because the room became vacant, I used the room for my guest during my wedding. I command today by the power of the Holy Ghost. Any witch in your environment.
Hey.
Any witch that in your environment.
Hey.
They shall run away.
Hey.
I say they shall run away.
Hey. Yes.
We are not living a gentility Christianity.
No, sir.
The Holy Ghost is radical.
Yes, sir.
Am I talking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
You need power. You need power. He said, we don't come with you with we kule kule. We came with demonstration of power. We demonstrate power among you. We demonstrate power. There is power. And that power is embedded on the Holy Spirit. He's embedded on the Holy Spirit. When you carry the power, you carry everything. Kala gaba yagaba. When you carry God, you carry everything. Kalabo shatalaba. When you carry God,
you carry everything.
Aya da 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 gaba yagaba yagaba.
When you carry God,
you carry everything.
You carry everything.
He's the owner of the world. Hallelujah. When you carry God,
you carry everything.
Oh yeah. When you carry God,
when you carry God,
you carry everything.
You carry everything.
He's the owner of the world. When you carry,
when you carry God,
you carry everything.
Oh yeah.
When you carry God,
you carry everything.
When you carry God,
you carry everything.
Oh yeah. afraid of him.
Yes, sir.
A man that carry God, anything as long God said the time has not come, there is nothing you can do. Just the below with the God he carry. They say, hey, you don't want to say renounce Jesus. You are still preaching to Jesus. The Bible says they put a hot oil. They were boiling oil. And they put him inside. He refused to die. Is somebody hearing me? Only a little when you are boiling oil. Or when you put oil in the fire, you are bleeding it. When a little of it jump out of the pot and bounce on your skin, what happened? But a whole man, John was put inside. But that place become an air condition. Somebody say power.
Power.
Power. When they try to kill him, they send him to the island of Patmos. Where nobody live. But there, the same Holy Ghost take care of him. The man that carry power. The Holy Ghost was with him. In a place surrounded by river, nowhere to go. And from there, he wrote the book of Revelation. Today, you are going home with this power.
Amen.
I say you are going home with this
Amen.
Power.
Amen.
I say you are going home with this power.
Amen.
You need it. Day two, he talk about the spirit filled life. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 7, he said, for God has not called us to impurity, but to holiness. The reason of the Holy Spirit is to live a holy life. To live what? A holy life. You cannot carry the Holy Ghost and still living in fornication. You cannot carry the Holy Ghost and you are still doing Yahoo Yahoo. You cannot carry the Holy Ghost and you are a prostitute. No! The Holy Ghost make you to live a holy life because his name is Holy. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. For them who must worship this God, but worship him in truth and in spirit. You must be holy. The spirit filled life must live a holy life. That was what we studied day two. Day three, he talked about hunger for spiritual power. This power don't just come, it comes to those who hunger for it. It comes for those that hunger for it. And Jesus told the disciples before his ascension, and he said, go to Jerusalem. Wait, tarry there until you are endued with the power from on high. Until you are endued with the power from on high. And the scripture said they were there, they gathered. They were praying. They were praying. First day came and go. They were praying. Second day came and go. They were praying. Third day came and go. They were praying. They were hungry for it. Are you hungry for the Holy Ghost this morning? Ask your neighbor, are you hungry for the Holy Ghost? They were hungry. And the third day, the day of Pentecost, the Bible said the Holy Ghost rested on them. Chapter 4, verse 31, the Bible said, and when they had prayed, the place was shaking. Where they were assembled together, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. The atmosphere where Holy Spirit shrine is the atmosphere of prayers. The atmosphere of what? Prayers.
Prayer.
Those who must hunger for the Holy Spirit must be hungry to pray. The first day when the apostles gathered, they were praying. The second day, they were praying. The third day, they were praying. Until in Acts of the Apostles chapter 2, the Bible says, and they were together with one accord, the Holy Ghost came. And after the Holy Ghost came, in this chapter 4, occasion, the disciples gathered and they were praying, and they were praying. The Holy Ghost came upon them and they were all filled. Why? Because they hunger for it. I will give you time today so that you will pray. Ask God, feed me, feed me, feed me, feed me. And that is when the Holy Spirit comes. The fourth lesson we study. Have you lost the fire? Are you here? You used to be filled before. You used to carry fire before. You are a man here. You are a woman here. You know how you were burning for God when you were youth. But today, it has become a super story, a big old story. It is your season. It is your season to return and carry the fire. Carry the fire. In Galatians chapter 3, verse 3, he said, "Are ye so foolish? Having begun in the spirit, are ye now made perfect by the flesh?" Are you made perfect by the flesh? The flesh will not allow you to carry the Holy Spirit. The flesh will not allow the Holy Spirit to come upon you. And that is why you need to leave the flesh. Because when you are in the flesh, the Holy Spirit will depart. It will depart. The Holy Spirit live in a life that is filled with God. Hallelujah. And the fifth lesson talk about the reason for the power. Why do we need the power? Why? We need the power to survive our terrain. If you don't have power, the enemy will continue to oppress you. Why do you need the power? You need the power for witness, to preach, to tell somebody that Jesus loves you. You need the power to witness. Why do we need power? We need the power for our protection. Why do we need power? We need the power for our direction. It's for our direction. Why do you need the power? You need it so that you can pray effectively. You need the power to pray effectively. But today, very quickly, we are looking into manifesting the power of the Holy Ghost. Now that you carry the Holy Ghost, you need to manifest it. You need to execute it. You need to what? Exercise it. Manifesting the power of the Holy Ghost. Tell your neighbor, manifest the power of the Holy Ghost. Display to all out of the Apostle chapter 10 verse 38. Out of the Apostle chapter 10 verse 38. Thank you, Jesus. Anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Amen. Father, bless the reading of your word today in our heart in the name of Jesus. Manifesting the power of the Holy Spirit. The book of Acts of the Apostles was written because the Holy Spirit empowered them to act. They acted in a manner that the world had never experienced. So the book was written because it was a book characterized by demonstrations of power. A book demonstrated, written to demonstrate that power was against power. And Jesus' power superior power. From the beginning to the end of the book of Acts of the Apostles, it's all about what? Power. With great an authority. The scripture said, Peter manifested on the day of Pentecost. He manifested. After the Apostle chapter 2, 14 to 40. We have no time to be reading them. Can take note of them. After the Apostle chapter 2, 14 to 40. Peter manifested the power. Peter, who was afraid of a little girl and denied Jesus. When the power came, he was able to stand before the Sadducees and the Sanhedrin. He was able to stand before the teacher, the priest, and the Levites. He was able to stand before all the scholars. Men who were academically sound. Peter was able to stand before them and say, men are better. What you are seeing today is not drunkenness. It is a prophecy that was said in the book of Joel chapter 2 verse 28 that in the last days I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. I will baptize my people with the Holy Ghost, and your sons and daughters shall begin to prophesy. The young one will see vision, and the old one shall dream dream. He said to them, this is what is happening today. Peter, an honorary fisherman that never go to school, began to break grammar. He began to speak big English. Why? Because the Holy Ghost have entered him. Today, Holy Ghost will enter somebody. Peter manifested. Manifested before them. After the Apostle chapter 3, 1 to 10. And they were going to the temple. The Bible says, at the hour of prayer, they met a regular customer that was always there to beg for money. And they said to him, today is not the day of begging. Tell your neighbor, today is not a day of begging. It's a day of freedom. Freedom from fear. Freedom of being in one position. I said to him, you cannot continue to remain here. Your time has come. They manifested. I said, Sivan ago, we have none. But that which we have, we give unto you. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, rise up and the lame man that had been there for many years. The Bible says, hearing the sound of Peter and John, he rose up. He rose up. He rose up. He did not only rise. The Bible said he began to jump. Yes, he began to jump. Yes. He began to jump. Yes. The Lord is changing somebody's level today. When you carry Holy Ghost, it does not allow you to remain in one place. Ayagaba, yagaba, yagaba. You know, the whole a madman cannot be in a place, in one place. The Holy God, he make you to be spiritually mad.
Yes, sir.
He make you not to remain in one position.
Yes, sir.
And the Bible says,
yes,
when he receives his healing,
yes,
he begin to jump.
Yes.
He begin to run.
Yes,
he was sleeping.
Yes.
Why? Because power has come.
Yes.
Today, power will enter you.
Amen.
Power will enter your house.
Amen.
Power will enter your house.
Amen.
If you believe it, let your amen sound like thunder.
Amen.
I will give you a tip very quickly. We will pray. We will pray. Because we will do more prayer. So that this power today, it is your season. Peter, they manifested. Is it Brother Philip? Brother Philip manifested. As he entered Samaria, he was preaching Christ. And the Bible says, as he was preaching Christ, he was doing miracles and healing people in the city. Out of the Apostle chapter 8, 5 to 8. As Philip entered Samaria, an evangelist He began to heal all manner of sickness. Miracles we are going on. Healing we are going on. Why? Because the Holy Ghost was like an electric in him. As you live here today, into that same house you used to stay, something new will be manifested in your life. The people of Samaria saw power. They saw power. What they have not seen before. What of our brother Stephen? He also manifests. The Bible says he manifested great wonders and miracle among the people. Give us Acts of the Apostles chapter 6 verse 8. Display it. Acts 6 verse 8. Stephen, he manifested before the people that his understanding they could not behold it. And look at it. And Stephen, full of what? Faith and power. Stephen was full of faith and power. He did great wonders and miracle among what?
The people.
Among what?
The people.
Among the people. You can't do great signs and wonder without what? Power. That is why you need power today. That's why you need power today. He did great signs and wonder. What a power. Power was manifested. That it was said that the people that turned the world upside down has come. They were men who turned the world upside down. Acts of the Apostles chapter 17 verse 6. Give it to us so that you will see. Acts of the Apostles chapter 17. Be very fast. Acts 17 verse 6. Look at it. Everybody read. 1, 2, go. And when they found them not, they drew Jason and certain brethren unto the rulers of the city, crying, these that have torn the wall upside down are come hither also. Malika lagabayagaba. If your environment still remain as it is, it means something have not entered you. Are you hearing me? If your environment still remain how it has been, it means something has not happened in your life. The people said of Paul and other Timothy that they are the people that turned the world upside down. The world became abnormal to the world. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. These are the people. You are going home different today. I said you are going home different today. Anything that is not of God, as you go home today, things will begin to change. Things will begin to change. In 2015, in Ozala experience, we are sharing time with our number. Where they wanted to finish our life. I don't want to say the story, but the boy that carried me on his back as we were coming, he said to me, why is it that only assemblies of God people now come they trespass this our land called Ozala? He said some days ago when Pastor Chris came to their village, he said he carried his Bible and put it on top of their idol died. Oh my God. Their idol was died. And he said to me, we again from assemblies of God, the river that no stranger goes to, it was apart from stranger does not go there. Even that day, it's not everybody that go there. That day was a sacred day that nobody supposed to enter that river. It was sacred. He said, una still go there, go spoil something. Today, you will spoil their child. As you arrive, they are to do the power they are using. By the power of the Holy Ghost, you will spoil them. You will spoil them. I say you will spoil them.
world upside down? How can the weak be comfortable in this church? How can the weak be comfortable in the Solula? We came with a change, with a radical anointing. No wonder when that guy was talking to us, he said, people, they are fighting from Oboni. They are fighting from Idumebo. They are saying, no, the man of God of this church cannot stay. Why? Because we are terrorizing. I pray prophetically. Oh,
yes.
Every occult temple,
yes, yes.
Every Oboni temple,
yes.
Every idol,
yes.
In the land of Irua,
yes.
As you shout about the cash fire,
yes.
I say the cash fire.
Yes.
I said they catch fire.
Amen.
You need not to remember the same. They turn the world upside down. They turn the world upside down. I see this changing. I see this turning around.
Amen.
I see this turning around.
Amen.
Am I talking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
That is what the power is all about. They turn the world upside down. Hear me, child of God. God have not changed. And the Holy Spirit have not changed also. Even the Bible have not changed too. It remains the same. There is no new revelation of the Bible that is the new later Bible. No, sir. It remains the same Bible of the old. Nobody is revising it. No new edition. It are no new edition. It remains the same Bible. If this apostle manifests, you will manifest. I say you will manifest. I say you will manifest. That amen is too gentle for me. Jesus was speaking in John chapter 14, verse 12. John chapter 14, verse 12. He was telling the disciples that, look at it. He said, verily, verily, I say unto you, ye that believe on me, the work that I do, shall he what? Shall he do also. No wonder the book of Acts was so corrosive. The book of I was so corrosive because Jesus told them, if you believe on me, the work that I do, you will do also. And he said, greater work than this, greater work than this one you are seeing, shall you do, because I go to my Father. No wonder Peter, his shadow could heal the sick. We were never told the shadow of Jesus healed the sick in the Bible. But because greater will be done by the power of the Holy Ghost, Peter's shadow begin to heal the sick. Today, when they hear your name, the sick shall be healed.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Your name alone, it can bring healing. And that is why there's many of you that believe your prophet here. Anytime you say the God of Reverend Okoji, the God of Pastor Otu, did he not answer you? He answered you. It is not only the God of Elijah. The Elijah is no more. The prophet of today, Okoji, is here. His name carry power.
Yes, sir.
His name carry anointing.
Yes, sir.
His name carry power.
Yes, sir.
His name carry healing.
Yes, sir.
Am I talking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
Pastor Otu is here.
Yes, sir.
His name carry power.
Power.
And that is why today, any sickness running over your body,
yeah,
is leaving you now.
Yeah.
I said it's leaving you now.
Yeah.
Greater work than this. That's what Jesus said. No limitation. No limitation in doing this work. No limitation at all. No limitation at all. Lipala gaba yagaba yagaba. And that is why today, in the days of Jesus, there was nothing called television. Today, even as I am speaking now, to those who believe wherever they are, only lay their hands upon the television, they can receive their miracle. No more barrier, because it is We are in the end time. The time to do greater by the power. The time to do greater work by the power is in you. Where is the power? Somebody say the power is in me.
The power is in me.
Shout the power is in me.
The power is in me.
You will manifest it today.
Amen.
I say you will manifest it today.
Amen.
Power. Greater work. Because of this power, there was no stagnation. The Bible says, and they were increasing in number. God was daily adding to the church. The essence of the power is for daily increase. The essence of the power is for what?
Daily increase.
Daily increase. If last 2 years, where you were, you were. Last year, where you were, you were. This year, where you were, you were. It's a sign the Holy Ghost is not in you. The Holy Ghost is not a monument. The Holy Ghost is a movement. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
The Holy Ghost is not what? A monument. The Holy Ghost is what?
A movement.
Today you are moving.
Amen.
Do you know what a monument is? A structure that you build. It does not live there. It remains there. In that Aho Junction, whether is it called by the moat there? It can never live there until trailer comes, demolition. It can only, it's a monument. Movement is somewhere something is moving from one position to another. And that is why when the Holy Ghost came, the apostle wanted to make the gospel a monument. They forgot what Jesus said in Acts of the Apostles chapter 1 verse 8. That when you receive power, you shall be my witness.
Yes, yes.
In Jerusalem,
yes, sir.
In Samaria,
yes, sir.
In Judea,
yes, sir.
In all over part
of the world.
But when the power came, they decide to remain in Jerusalem. They decide to remain. And when they decide to remain, God raised persecution. Before you know it, TV was killed. They killed TV to open their eyes that the gospel is not to remain in Jerusalem. The gospel cannot be a monument. The gospel is a movement. The gospel is going here into the world and preach the gospel, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. I speak to somebody. Today is your day of Holy Ghost baptism. Today is your day of baptism.
Amen.
It's a movement. Somebody shout movement.
Movement.
And that is why by the power you carry today, you will no longer be settled in one place.
Amen.
The power shall also be corrosive.
Amen.
That if you don't go out for evangelism,
amen,
you will not rest.
Yes.
You will be like Jeremiah. He said, for the fire was burning, it was burning in my pole. The anointing was burning in my pole.
Yes.
Even when I say I want to be quiet,
yes,
I see myself speaking.
Yes.
Even when I say I will not pray, I see myself compassionate. Why? Because the anointing is like a fire.
When you put a life rat or human being in a fire, can you be comfortable?
No, sir.
That is how the Holy Ghost is.
Yes, sir.
Where is he? You can't remain in one place. Today, the Holy Ghost will make you to move.
Amen.
I say it will move you.
Amen.
I say it will move you.
Amen.
Take the power. Take the power. Quickly before we pray. Areas where we can manifest this power. Number one, we are to manifest it by preaching the gospel and win souls for the Lord. Matthew chapter 10 verse 7. Acts of the Apostles chapter 10 verse 44. Matthew 10 7, if you can display it. The reason where we manifest this power is how we preach to people. And as they go, preach. As you go, preach. Say the kingdom of heaven is what? At hand. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. In manifesting this power is you leaving your comfort zone to preach to somebody. The reason why the world is not pushing us is because we are now too comfortable in one place. Go out and preach to those in the hotels. Go out and preach to those in the prostitute house. Go out and preach to those in beer joints. Go out and preach to those in the smoky joints. That there is a lot of power. Go out. Preach to them. Hey, my God, John Knox of Scotland, when he saw that there was no salvation, no believer in Scotland, he prayed, give me Scotland as I die. Give me Scotland. Lord, I need Scotland for Jesus.
Hear me. After today, Irua shall be for Jesus.
Amen.
I don't care the power that are ruling now.
No.
But after this encounter, Irua shall be for Jesus.
Amen.
It's for us to preach. With that, do we manifest this power? By healing all manner of sickness and diseases. Matthew chapter 10, verse 1. And the Bible says, Jesus, Matthew 10 verse 1, if you can display it. And Jesus called in the disciples to him. He called them to him. He gave them power. He gave them power to cast out demons and to heal all manner of sicknesses and all manner of diseases. Matthew 10 verse 1. Jesus, he gave them power. Power to do what? To cast out devils. That is the essence of the power. Cast out devils. By the grace of God, through our Father here, how many demonized children, women, and others that have come here that God has delivered? That is the essence of the power. That is the essence of the power. A girl was brought here from Lagos. Last 2 years, I've been there about from Lagos. She was possessed. And when the auntie saw that she was possessed, because one of the nights, they told the girl to bring the child of the auntie she was staying with. And the child was staying with her in the room. All of a sudden, this auntie here, that the girl began to shout, hey, I will not give way. I will not give the child. And the mother ran. And said, I begin to tell the auntie, sit there, they say I should bring the child. Sit there. Auntie, oh, it's midnight. I know they see anything. And the mother carried her child. It was from there he knew that this girl have a strange power. And he carried the child to our pastor. And the pastor said, it is just an imagination. And give her rhapsody or reality. Make she the reader. Let her be reading rhapsody or reality. It's her imagination. And the auntie decided to call her sister that's our member. And said, see you. And the sister said, come, our pastor can pray for this child. And be normal. And that is how they came. They were coming. The day they were coming, the power knew that if she reached here, something will happen. He decided the first car they entered, engine knocked. The guy knocked the engine of the car. They entered another one. For them not to reach here, the same power sent armed robber on the way to kill them. But God still delivered them. And finally, they landed here. And when they landed here, power jam, power. Kala gaba ya gaba. We are not joking, because the power of the Holy Ghost is real. Somebody
at her. Even this girl did not know where she was staying. She began to ask, where did bring me to this place? Where am I? She saw her auntie. I asked her auntie, now you are the stay with. She has stayed with her auntie. She was staying in another place before. Over a year that the auntie carried her stay with her, she never knew she was staying with her auntie. She thought it was the former place. He said, auntie, what thing are they do with you? Where the other former uncle I am staying with? I'm talking about satanic power. Satanic power. Today, any power that hurts you, today is your day of freedom.
Amen.
I say it's your day of freedom.
Amen.
He gave them power to cast out devils. No devil resists the name of Jesus. He said, they never be given. That is above every other name. And the name of Jesus, every name must what?
Must bow.
And that name is for healing. Are you sick here? The reason of the power of the Holy Ghost is for your healing. I told you how sickness tormented me for many years. He tormented me for many years. But when I have the knowledge that the Holy Ghost did not come to only save me, he also came to heal me. He came to heal me. When I know it, today, it is not a story. No more sickness for you. I said no more sickness for you.
Amen.
Enough is enough. Or boasting of my family doctor. My family doctor. What a nonsense. Every month you are visiting family doctor. Your family doctor is riding a car. You don't ride. Your family doctor is using your money, building a house. You still remain a tenant. Your family doctor is sending his children to abroad to school. Your child, there is no money to go to school. But every month you spend for the doctor. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. You need power to stop that sickness. Any sickness, terminal disease, any seasonal disease that is always coming to collect your money.
Go.
Any sickness
Go.
That is always coming to take away your job.
Go.
Any sickness
yes.
That is taking your effort.
Yes.
Today, as you shout to me,
yes.
He's leaving you now.
Go.
I said he's leaving you now.
Go.
Any sickness you are spending upon every month as you echo amen. Today it dry up. Today it dry up. Today it dry up. Today it dry up. Let your amen roar like thunder.
Amen.
He gave us power to heal all manner of diseases. All manner of sickness and diseases. Anemia is among them. Coronavirus is among them. HIV is among them. Diabetes is among them. Sugar disease is among them. Fever, malaria, ulcer, whatever name they be, they are not about the name of Jesus. A name has been given. He gave them power. I say, heal all manner of sickness here. I don't know the name. The doctor call your sickness.
Hey.
Today,
yes,
that sickness is over.
Amen.
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 Jump up and shout amen like thunder.
Amen.
You can do without hospital. Yes. You can do without hospital. The essence of the power is to bind up the brokenhearted. Isaiah 61 verse 1. Isaiah 61 verse 1. And the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He have anointed me to preach the gospel. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He have anointed me to bind all the brokenhearted. The
essence of the power of the Holy Ghost is those who the enemy have bastardized. Is those who the enemy have put in one condition. Is for you to bind them together. Encourage them that there is still hope. There is what? Still hope. That is the essence of the Holy Ghost. When you carry the Holy Ghost, you will not add injury, insult to an injury. When my brother died, I was telling one woman, I said, my brother died. Do you know what she said? She said, oh, this death itself. If this your brother, not just go church where now. Now, her fire, she just they go. I said, now that one be the encouragement. Whether it's he go church or no go church, no be that one first. Is encourage me. So people don't know how to encourage. It's in our FIA, not be here. We say we don't die now with the talk first. The Holy Spirit will give you the right knowledge to encourage person in any condition that God can say this person. When you are in a place you don't know what to say, keep quiet. Keep quiet. The reason of the Holy Ghost is to bind up the heart that have been scattered. Many people, their heart have been scattered. Many marriages have been scattered. The answer of the Holy Ghost is to bring them together. Two couples came to you for settlement. You now scatter them anymore. You don't have the Holy Ghost. No matter the offense, your own should be, you must come back together. It's not a you woman, you are bad. Man, you are bad. If I were you, I'm not going to marry him again. No, that is not the right word. Number four, proclaim liberty, freedom. Everybody say freedom. Freedom. John chapter 8, verse 32 and 36. And Jesus said, you will know the truth, and the truth will make you all free. In verse 36, he said, whoever the Son of Man shall be set free is free war indeed. The power of the Holy Ghost will set you free today.
Amen.
I said it will set you free today.
Amen.
Let me rush it. Number five, opening of the prison to them that are bound. Acts of the Apostles chapter 12, 5 to 10. Acts 16, 23 to 26. With the power of the Holy Ghost, anybody in prison is loose. In Acts of the Apostles 12, 5 to 10, Peter was in prison. When the church prayed, he was released. Paul and Silas were in prison in verse 1, in chapter 16. And the Bible says, they begin to sing and pray. Before you know it, there was an earthquake. There was what? An earthquake. And prison doors were open. Those that were bound, the Bible said they were what? Loose. It was not only Paul and Silas that were loose. All the prisoners with them were loose. By that same power. I don't know who is connected to you that the enemy have put in the prison. Because of you today, they are leaving that prison.
Amen.
They are leaving that prison. Kala gaba yagaba. Libra dada gaba yagaba. The essence of the power is to raise the dead. Another one, to cast out devils. To subdue and overcome all the power of the enemies. Rise on your feet this morning. Rise on your feet. Do you need this power? Do you need this power? How can you manifest? How can you manifest? For you to manifest, you are going to pray. You must be born again. John 3:3. Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. He can enter. Born again is a prerequisite. Number two, you must deliberately ask to receive it. Luke chapter 11, verse 13. For you to receive it, you must believe in him. You must pray for it. The Holy Ghost does not just come. It is for those who need it. Can you take a step of faith? Kalagaba, take a step of faith. The Holy Ghost is here. Don't go without this Holy Spirit. Spread yourself.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Father.
I know you are here.
Bless the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
I know you are here. Sweet Holy Spirit.
I know you are come, Jesus.
You are come
to bring revival. I know you are here.
Bless
the Holy Spirit. I know you are here.
Precious Holy Spirit.
Open your heart. Open your heart. Open your heart. Open your heart.
I know
you are here.
Sweet Holy Spirit.
Jesus.
You have come to bring revival.
Papa,
I know you are here.
Let the Holy Spirit. Oh, I know you are here. Lift up your hands and wave for Jesus. Precious Holy Spirit. Get yourself ready. It is here. I know you are here.
Sweet Holy Spirit,
I know you are coming, Jesus.
You have come
to be revived. I know you are here.
Bless
the Holy Spirit. I say, I know you are here. Open your heart. It's all over here.
Sweet
Holy Spirit. It's all over here. It's all over here.
I know you are coming.
You are
going
to be revived. I know you are here. This is a crucial time. It cannot come where sin dwells. It cannot come where sin lives. If you are sincere within yourself, in a minute, can you begin to confess to Jesus now? Ask God for His mercy right now. Ask God for mercy right now. Ask God for mercy now. Ask God for mercy now.
To you.
Are you serious with this power at all? If you are serious, ask God. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Pray. Ask God.
We did nothing.
Even the apostles, they didn't just receive it, they prayed.
But your mood now shows that you don't even need it, because the level of your prayer life is as if you think I'm joking here. It doesn't jump on person, it is for those that are willing.
Yes.
You must learn to pray. They pray for 10 days. It is 7 days we have been now. Since on Monday we have been asking God for this power. For I've been asking God, it's time and say, God, this power, let it come upon me. Put your two hands on your head. Put your two hands on your head. Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
Say, oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
I have come to you today.
I have come to you today.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As we have been waiting.
As we have been waiting.
For this power.
For this power.
Today.
Now.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Let the power.
Let the power.
Come upon me.
Come upon me.
Come upon me.
Come upon me.
Come upon me. Open your mouth and pray. Take over. He's here to touch everyone here tonight.
Now,
are you a guy? Are you a boy?
He's here.
Are you a man?
Receive the power.
Are you a woman?
Receive the power.
The Holy God is here.
Yes.
You want to invite him now?
Yes, Lord.
You this one to invite him into your life?
Yes, Holy Ghost.
As you seek him from the depths of your heart, it will fall on you. It will fall on you. Come.
Holy Ghost, come.
Come.
Holy Ghost, come.
Oh yeah.
Holy Ghost, come.
Oh, Don't be silent. Yes. 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 Don't struggle with him. Don't struggle with it.
Easier.
Don't struggle with it.
Easier.
Allow him in. Allow him in. Allow him to enter you. Allow him to enter you. He's here. He's here. He's here. He's here. He's here.
Yes.
Wherever you are, close your eyes. Wherever you are. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
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 Yes, yes,
he's here. He's here. Yes,
yes,
he's here.
Yes,
he's here.
Take a hold.
He's here.
Take a hold.
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 Holy Ghost.
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 Holy Ghost. Y'all be quiet. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
As many that have been tarrying, until we tarry, we cannot carry.
Oh, yes.
Those of you that are sitting there, rise on your feet. You can't go home the same way you came.
Oh, yes.
Librata kapala bayagaba.
Shata bayagadaba.
Holy Ghost, don't be tarrying. Father, Father, all over the General Council of Assemblies of God, Nigeria.
Yes.
This is what we are talking about today. Another Pentecostal churches, by that same anointing, by that same grace,
move.
Father,
yes.
As many that have been crying out to you, in their secrets, Father, they are here.
Yes.
Even though they have lost the fire, like I said, God, I need more of the fire, wherever they are. Under this house,
yes.
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 Under this house, yes. Yes,
yes.
Yes,
yes.
Yes,
yes.
Yes,
yes.
Yes, yes.
Yes,
yes. Yes,
yes.
Yes,
yes.
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes.
Yes,
yes.
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes.
Yes,
yes. Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Yes,
yes.
Yes, shall receive power.
Yes.
After which the Holy Ghost has come upon you. My God, my God. Everybody put your two hands on your head. Put your two hands on your head.
Yes.
As I count 1 to 5. Father. Father, you said in your word. You confirmed the word of your servant and the two the counsel of the messenger. Lord, as many who have been waiting for you, waiting for this power, as I count 1 to 5,
yes.
My God, my God, wherever they are, among the guys, among the boys, among the men, among the women,
Pastor.
Now let the Holy Ghost come upon them.
Yes.
Number 1. As I repeat it again, as I shout number 1, you say, Holy Ghost, come upon me. Shout it very well. Something will happen now. Something will happen now.
Yes, yes.
Chain will be broken now.
Yes.
The sick will be healed now.
Yes.
Your prayer will be delivered now.
Yes, yes, yes.
Prison door shall be broken. Number 1.
Holy Ghost, come upon me.
Yes,
it's on you.
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 It's on you.
Where is that?
It's on you.
It's on you.
Where is that?
It's on you.
Where is that guy?
It's on you.
Where is that man?
It's on you.
Where is that man?
Yes, yes.
Holy Ghost. Number 2.
Holy Ghost,
come upon me. Number 3.
Holy Ghost,
come upon me. Father, where are they? Where are they?
It's on you.
Where are they?
It's
where are they?
Plus.
Look at them now.
Plus.
Look at them.
Plus.
Look at them.
Yes.
Look at them.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Number 4.
Holy Ghost, come upon me.
Yes. This last one now. Something is happening. At my right, at my left. At the center here.
Holy Ghost.
Something is happening.
Holy Ghost.
Something is happening.
Holy Ghost.
Something is happening.
Holy Ghost.
Empowerment.
Yes.
Empowerment.
Yes. Yes.
Empowerment.
Yes.
Empowerment.
Yes.
As we mention this last one.
Yes. 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 Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Like a flame of fire.
Yes.
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 No more fire.
Holy Ghost. Come on, baby.
Yes. It's on you now.
Come on.
Yes. 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 Yes.
Yes,
You have not spoken tongue before.
It's all over you.
The power we want to rest on you.
Yes.
Lika lakaba yakaba.
It's all over you.
La the days of Pentecost. Fire follow me. Iya la lakaba yakaba. La the days of Pentecost. Oh yeah. Fire follow me. Holy Ghost.
Whoa.
Fire, follow me.
Baba,
light the days of Pentecost.
Ikala da 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 da.
Follow me.
Holy Ghost.
Power,
power,
power.
Fire follow me.
Lose it now.
Jesus,
power. But you, I am nothing at all.
Hold it. Hold your hands together. You are here. You are not spoken in tongue before.
Thou power of God.
Hold your hands together.
Thou power of God.
The power will so be mighty.
Is coming down.
Don't lean down and hold your hand together, everybody. Don't lean down. Hold your hands. Make now stand up for altar. Hold your hands together. Stand up. Kalakabayagaba. Join your hands together.
Ikabado zobrayagada.
The power of the Holy Ghost wants to come upon you. You have not spoken in tongue before. You have lost your fire before. It is time.
Yes.
It is time.
Yes.
It is time.
Yes.
You don't speak in tongue once in a year. It is not once in a year you speak in tongue. Speaking in tongue is daily, every second and every minute.
Oh yes,
Father, this is the time.
Yes,
this is the time.
Close
until you carry the Holy Ghost, you will be like a chaff.
Yes,
Father, as many that are desiring, as many that have lost this power,
revive,
Lord, Lord. In this one more time,
yes.
Holy Spirit of God,
Revater.
Let the fire fall.
Yes.
Let the fire fall.
Let it come.
Let the fire fall.
Let it come there.
Hold on, there. Malika lipa lete.
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Equator.
Now.
Yes, yes.
The fire, the fire.
Yes, yes.
Anywhere you are.
Let it come.
Wherever you are.
We connect.
Fire. Connection, incarnation.
Yes.
As many.
Yes.
That are desiring this Holy Ghost.
Ayika.
Wherever they are, wherever they are,
fire,
God, that I love the fire,
fire of God,
Is here
and the power of the Holy Ghost
at my right.
Yes,
at
and the center,
the power,
and the left,
the power.
Yes,
the power.
It is your turn.
Yes,
it is your turn.
Yes,
it is your turn.
You must run.
1, 2, 3.
Carry the power.
Yes. Yes.
Ah.
Don't be a looker.
Ah.
Don't be an inspector. Something is happening inside you.
Yes.
Dog woman. Dog woman.
The fire is
dog woman. Something is happening to you. It's all over here. Here, here, here. Yes, 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 yes. Take out. Take out. Take out. Power.
Ooh.
Let there be activation. Activation, 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 all the power, all the power, all the power, take, 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 take,
take,
take,
take, take,
move.
Now, now, now,
thank you, Father.
Now, ah,
thank you, Jesus.
Look at the spirit. Look at the spirit. Look at the spirit.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Look at the spirit. I can feel it now.
One more time.
Look at the spirit.
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 One more time.
Angels of God.
Fire.
Aha! 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 Sha-ta-ta-ta.
That is it!
Aha!
Holy Ghost!
Something is going on!
Holy Ghost!
The fire is burning! Aha!
Holy Ghost, take over!
Give her a mic! He said you are too far. It's not by force.
Sha-ta-ta.
He can't jump on you. The Holy Ghost cannot jump on you.
Open your heart.
They are looking at me. Open your
heart.
Jesus is the owner of the church. Yes, he's here.
You are too far for me to receive me. You are too far for me.
Among the men, be close. Among the women, be close.
Oh yes.
I'm here. I'm here.
Oh, shut up.
I'm here for you. I'm here for you. You are too far for me. Receive me. Receive me. Receive me. You will see my you will see my power. Look at my grace. Look at my grace. Look at my grace. Look at my power. Look at my power. Look at my power.
Aha.
You are too far for me.
Yes. Something's going
it's
on.
It's here.
It's going on.
Don't go home without your own.
A super rata.
Don't go home without your own.
Something's going on.
Yes. Yes.
Aha.
Yes.
Aha.
Open your hearts.
Something's happening.
God is here.
Something's happening.
Yes. Carry the power.
Carry your own.
Carry
your own. Your own.
Don't be a monument without power. Don't be an usher without power. Don't be a tourist without power.
Oh yes.
That is why if you go without the power today, you only do yourself.
Yes.
It be one more time. Anywhere you are,
power of God.
As I shall 1, 2, 3,
power of
let the power follow you.
Yes, now.
1, 2, 3. Carry your power.
Yes. Aha. Aha.
Yes.
It's on you.
Yes.
It's on you.
Yes.
It's on you.
Yes.
It's sent you.
Yes.
It's sent you.
Yes.
It's on you.
Yes.
It's on you.
Yes.
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 Power.
Yes. Yes. Ah. Oh, yes.
Speak in tongues. Speak in tongues.
Shatakabaya.
The men are not, they are not there. The chorister, they are not there.
Oh.
You don't need the Holy Ghost.
Open your heart.
It does not jump on you. Yes. He's all over.
The power of God.
He's all over.
He's everywhere.
My da.
He's everywhere.
The if you don't carry your own, you are, it's your fault. If you don't carry your own, it's your fault.
Shut
if
up.
You don't carry your own, it's your fault. All of them were battered. On the days of Pentecost.
Yes.
Right now.
Yes.
My God. My God,
my God,
my God, anyone see desire it, anyone see desire it, my God, lay your hands on them, lay your hands on them,
oh yes,
among the choristers, among the men, among the women, carry the power,
yes,
carry the power,
yes,
carry the power,
Holy Ghost,
carry the power,
Holy Ghost,
yes, be quiet. Don't look at me, be quiet. Speak it out. Speak in tongues. That is the power.
Yes.
That is the power.
Yes.
They can't deny you of it. It's a free gift. It's a free gift.
Oh yeah.
It's a free gift.
Oh yeah.
It's a free gift.
Oh yeah.
Carry.
Carry your own.
Carry.
Carry your own.
Carry.
Carry your own.
Carry the power.
Carry your own. Nah.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus.
My God.
It's the same message. Open your heart.
Put your heart.
The same message. Thank you, Father.
Shakaya. Shakaya.
Kaya lagana.
Shakaya daba.
Kala kabayaka. Libra daga. Thank you, Jesus.
Shakaya.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Put your two hands on your head. Are you sick here? Are you in prison here? By the mercies of God, I decree over your life, let every infirmity disappear.
Amen.
Let every deadly disease disappear.
Amen.
Ulcer disappear.
Yes.
Cancer disappear.
Yes.
Tumor disappear.
Yes.
Anemia disappear.
Yes.
Waste disappear.
Yes.
Affliction of the leg go.
Yes.
Hyper go.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name. If you know the Lord touch you, just come here.